The video ran for me.
Hare Rama. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya.
Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya.
Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya.
Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya.
Not so easy to come to Ganges Bank.
It is due to your own meritorious deeds and a noble intention. With great effort, you are in a position to come spend at least 2 months here. This holy place is called Munikiriti, and many sages trodden this earth. Even this place is so much well known, even in the ancient scriptures, Ramayana and Mahabharata. Rama brothers also did penance on the Ganges bank. Even Pandava brothers also went from here for their final abode on Mahaprasthana. And this is a very, very holy place. You are very fortunate to be here, to spend these 2 months here. This is called basic Yoga Vedanta course. And the worship Gurudev purposely, knowingly kept this Yoga Vedanta. Yoga and Vedanta is not ordinary things. Se Vyasa glorifies Nasti Sankhya Samam Jnanam Nasti Yoga Samam Dhanam. It means there is no knowledge greater than the knowledge of the self, and there is no power greater than the power of yoga. Here we are going to learn this Yoga and Vedanta, which is very, very important to lead a peaceful life on this planet here. And yoga is very, very important. Saint Vyasa beautifully explains, because in the name of yoga many people do many things, but Saint Vyasa warns about this. He said beautifully, yogo yogena gnatavyam, yogo yoga pravartate, apramatena yogena sayogi ramate charam. Yogo yogena gnatavyam, yoga can be learned, known only by practice. Yoga is not merely a theory. Yogo yogena gnatavyam, yogo yoga pravartate, only by regularly practicing yoga, yoga reveals. And what it is, our worshipful Krishnani Maharaj again emphasizes one of the important aspects of yoga. Apramatena yogena, yoga means vigilance. One should practice yoga with supreme vigilance. That vigilance is called yoga. Hence, by practicing yoga vigilantly, one can establish in yoga. Yogo yogena gnatavyam, yogo yoga pravartate, apramatena yogena means vigilance. Sayogi ramate charam, such a yoga practitioner alone can exist, remain in yoga one's throughout life. Hence yoga is very, very important aspect of life. Our worshipful Gurudev, he was a normal physical doctor in Malaysia, working in rubber plantations. And being a doctor, he realized, there's a well-known proverb, doctor gives medicine, it is God who cures the disease. He wants to know what is the God principle in human body, God particle. Nowadays it becomes a particle like that. He wanted to know what it is. Hence he came from Malaya to Himalaya. And personally he wanted to practice it, and he wanted to share that experience with others. And he wrote many books on yoga and Vedanta. And this is the place Worshipful Gurudev lived here. And it was here, it's only really a forest here. Nowadays, after 70s, buildings came into existence. Even daytime people won't come here, because it's a big forest here. And it's called a forest academy. And we are very fortunate to stay here. But as he said, our Registrar Swamiji, Yogavendranath Maharaj, here this academy is not ordinary academy. Here the professors are, it is not a theoretical learned professors. They want to share their personal experience. Here, in these 2 months, we are able to know what is spiritual life. There are so many religions are there. It is not a religious life, it is a spiritual life. You know the difference between religious life and spiritual life? In religious life, in the name of religion, in the name of God, they fight. But if you are a spiritual person, you understand the essence of all religions and live to its own basic fundamental principles of life. That is called life in the spirit. Here, in the 2 months, you know what to do, how to live, how to think, and how to share your experience. This is a practical, basic Yoga Vedanta course. Our worshipful Gurudev wrote many things. Among them, whether you like it or not, first principle you will have to, 20 important instructions, you will have to practice it. Whether you like it or not, you will know it and you will experience it. First spiritual instruction is, get up at 4 a.m. That will make you to do it. In the beginning, first few days, you feel little uneasy. At first, you will not like to sleep. Automatically will get up. That is the beauty of this academy, this atmosphere. It becomes a spontaneous to your life to live spiritually. Because body is there. We live in bodily level. And we are more conscious of the body. And so, Swamiji will teach you. Devabhakta and Maharaj will teach you the yogasanas and pranayamas. I know many people are yoga exponent, but here it is practically you will see how the difference is there when compared to other yoga centers and here. And Swami Sivananda and Swami Chidani Maharaj, practically they lived in that life and they instructed how to live, how to practice yogasanas and pranayamas. A set of yogas and pranayamas will make you to get rid of body consciousness. And a set of pranayamas, by doing it, even you know how to breathe properly, because we also breathe, but much of the toxins are held up in our lung. By doing pranayamas properly, you know how to breathe. Then our assistant registrar and other faculty members will teach you how to think. Thinking is very, very important. Because in the beginning, right thinking is very important. And after right thinking, automatically, mind also will go beyond all the good and bad thinking. It transcends it. Hence, our worshipful Gurudev create such atmosphere here. All the 24 hours for the past nearly 70 years, 75 years, this Mahamantra Kirtan is going on. Our Gurudev is got so much insistent about repetition of God's name. God's name is the panacea to cure physical, vital, mental, psychological limitations. Being a doctor, Swami has got so much faith in repetition of God's name. Hence, my humble request to you, when you are here, try to do japa as much as possible. And when I came to the ashram, Chidani Maharaj said, if you want to stay in the ashram, very, very important thing is, there are some G's. First is, read Bhagavad Gita. Then, always remember Govinda, second G. Third G is Ganga. You are very, very fortunate to hear, daily go and see. But one instruction is, never go alone to Ganges. You must go with other person. Nowadays, someone is coming. You can take bath in a Hanuman Ghat. It's very safety. Some railings are there. You can don't go alone. Always 2-3 persons should go take bath. And third is Ganga. Fourth is Gayatri. Repetition of God's name as much as possible. Then, feel the presence of Guru. That is, in the beginning, it's called Guru Seva. But there is another sixth G one should avoid. You know what it is? Gossip. And instead of gossip, repeat God's name. And so that 2 months you spend here, that will be more useful to you. And after going back, you are not aware of what has happened to you. Your family members and friends will know complete transformation will take place. Now you are coming here as a participants of the 88 basic Yoga Vedanta course. When you go back, you know what will be your duty and responsibility? You are going as a representative of Gurudev Swami Sivananda Maharaj. And here, in these 2 months, you know what to do, what not to do, then you will be good. Then after 2 months staying here, learning all the set of asanas, pranayama, japa, meditation, hearing different talks by our experienced faculty members, and whatever you do, it will be not only good to you, good to others. And that is the thing, be good and do good. This is the essence of all religions, all the scriptures. Still Vyasa beautifully said, Ashtadasa Puranana, Saram Saram Samudritam, Paropakaraya Punyaya Papaya Parapedanam. Doing good to others is meritorious. Doing harm is a sin. And here, in our religion, especially in divine life, there is no place for sin, no sinner at all. Our Swami Gurudev, someone asked him, have you seen God? He saw nothing but divinity of God in all names and forms. That is one of the essential line, fundamental line, fundamental principle of universal prayer of Gurudev. And that is our aim in life also, to see divinity in all names and forms. And these 2 months, you are very fortunate to understand it and live in that spirit. Then you go back, you will go as a completely transformed being. This is my humble request and prayer to the Almighty God and worshipful Gurudev. And spend your time doing maximum japa. And another important thing is, even you may know many points when the faculty members talk, but put the timings, put the points, even if you know it, write it down. When you go back, that will be great, useful to you, what you heard, what you do it, then you can assimilate things and then think over it. And take it a note every time, whatever professor tells, faculty member tells, make a note, timings and date, all these things, so that it will be more useful to you when you go back to your place, you can assimilate it. And then you can live a divine life of truth. Divine life is to negate the animal in man, to convert the human into divine, is called a divine life. All our, we are human beings. The good and bad will be there. No one is beyond error. That is a beautiful saying in Ramayana. In the Ramayana, Valmiki put this statement, Nakaschit Naparajyati. No one is beyond error. Because as a human being, we will do some mistakes. As a human, there is to do error is natural, but to forgive it is divine. That divine quality will come to us, because no one is beyond error. Simultaneously, by thinking properly, reading the scriptures, naturally we can change our way of thinking. On the other hand, we can understand the limitation of human mind. Then you can love for everything, because that is the life divine. Understand it, transcend it, then you can be feeling the presence of divine, because God is all pervading. Because not to see God is a wonder. Because of the wrong perception, wrong thinking, we are not able to grasp it, see it. On the other hand, by right thinking, it is called a satsang. You've got a very good opportunity to sit and hear many people, whether like it or not. This opportunity will never come to you again in your lifetime. And utilize this opportunity, because many people, as I said, from alien states you come, it is impossible for you to meet again. It's a very good opportunity for you. Live in that spirit, learn it, and take notes, and then spend your time on the candle band by repeating God's name as much as possible. That is your real gain. Even whether you like it or not, after going back, a question will come, what have I done? Then this, no negative answer will come, oh, I did a good repetition of God's name. That the greatest gain for you, and repeat God's name, and so that you will be good, and whatever you do, it is not only good to you, good to others. And so be good and do good. And here, take all the notes and go back as a transformed member of the Divine Society. And not only that, my humble request to you, when you go back, make it a point to make a study group of Bhagavad Gita, any other scripture, and teach yoga, at least for minimum 5 people. And even 40 people, teach at least your own friends. By teaching, you learn more. That is very, very important thing, yoga. And when you go there, you teach so that you regularly practice it, and that will be a very good benefit for your friends and relatives. Hence, utilize the time, and when this disturbance period will go back, our Sivabhaktani will take care of you, for Registrar, Assistant Registrar, and others. They will take care of you more than your members of our family. And free from all anxiety, don't think 2 months is long. 2 months will go just like 2 minutes. And be good, be happy, and be kind, and be healthy. Is my heart for you. Wish you all the best.
Thank you, Swami Maharaj.